Okay, good morning everybody. Good morning. Today we're going to start with Unit 7. Ya estamos un poco como que atrasadas. Recuerden que la unidad 7 es del bloque 5 y el bloque 5 está. Pero bueno, no importa. Unit 7. So today we're going to work on pages 76 and 77 of the student book. So open your books on page 76. Please. Okay, in this, today we're going to have the first activity is to introduce new vocabulary related to New York life, because this unit is all about the United States, okay? A word of warning as the name of a unit. And in this lesson, we're going to learn new vocabulary related to New York life. Very easy, the vocabulary. And in the second activity of this page, we're going to have a reading activity. This is a quiz about New York. Okay, let's begin by doing this activity. You're going to categorize the words in three different categories: arts, entertainment, sports, fast food, and transportation. So place the words in the correct column. We have theater, hamburger, museum, ferry, taxi cab, subway, hot dog, bagel, ice ring, and boss. Ay.
What's a ferry?
Ferry is a kind of transportation. Ya después vamos a ver eso. El que no sepa, no ubique, ¿no? No importa, este es vocabulario nuevo.
No me pide.
Finish. Okay, this is very easy. Let's see, Amy. What did you write in arts, entertainment, and sports?
Museum.
Museum, what else?
Theater.
Theater.
Ice rink.
Ice rink. Do you know the meaning of an ice rink? This is a place where people go to ice skating, okay? Es como una pista de patinaje, okay? Theater, museum, and ice rink, correct. Emilia, fast food.
Hamburger, hot dog, and bagel.
Bagel. Do you know the meaning of bagel? Es como una...
Rosquilla.
Sí, como una rosquilla, una, ¿cómo le llaman aquí que venden los venezolanos, sobre todo las donas? No, bueno, es que dona no es lo mismo, rosquilla. Ok, bagel, hamburger and taxi and hot dog. And transportation, Abigail, means of transportation, medios de transporte.
Ferry, taxi. Taxi cab,
y bus, correct. Taxi cab is the same of taxi, okay? It's the same to say taxi. So, recuerden que este vocabulario sobre Nueva York, o sea, estas palabras son muy utilizadas o típicas de lo que es el New York, Estados Unidos de manera general, New York specifically. So, dice, ¿alguna duda con estas palabras? Está fácil. Okay, este es el vocabulario. Este es el vocabulario fundamental y esto que yo recuerde lo tengo en prueba. New York Life. Muy fácil. Dice en item B, write two more words in each column. A ver, vamos a agregar dos palabras más en cada columna que tenga que ver con los Estados Unidos, con New York. Ok. In arts, entertainment and sports. ¿Quién me puede agregar dos palabras? ¿Mm?
Basketball.
Baseball stadium. Eso es típico de los Estados Unidos. Basketball is a sport, the national sport of the USA. Baseball stadium, you know that the baseball, it's play in the USA, okay? People in the USA play baseball a lot and basketball too. So, baseball stadium, movie theater, no es lo mismo theater que movie theater. Theater es el teatro y el movie theater es el cine, ¿ok? Ok, let's see, in fast food. Two more words. Pizza. McDonald's. Bueno, las McDonald's son hamburgers. Aquí tengo sub sandwich, que sería el submarino. Es un tipo de sándwich típico de los Estados Unidos. Se le llama sub de submarine, sub sandwich. Un sándwich que se le llama submarino, muy típico de los Estados Unidos. Y tengo aquí el burrito. This is from Mexico, but as in the USA live too many Mexicans, a lot of Mexicans, so the burrito became a typical food in the USA. Burrito. Transportation. Amy me había preguntado el ferry. En la próxima actividad vamos a ver lo que is a kind of transportation. Is a ship that carries people and goods also. Es un tipo de barco que transporta sobre todo personas, pero también mercancía. Es un ferry, ¿no? Así mismo se llama en español. Ok, two more. Bueno, bike, bicycle, train, airplane. Subway. Bueno, aquí queda ya, yo no les hice PowerPoint para el vocabulario porque está súper fácil. Aquí queda hasta categorizado el vocabulario. Este es el vocabulario fundamental relacionado con la vida en Nueva York. Ya tienen. Very easy. Esta palabrita que es un bagel se le llama a sí mismo en español. Bagel. Es como una rosquilla, bagel. Deja ver si en lo que escriben yo encuentro aquí bagel. Ay, esto está lento. Here you have some pictures of bagels. Rosquillas. Okay. Ok, finish. ¿Dudas con el vocabulario? Bueno, no creo porque está súper fácil. Recuerde la diferencia entre theater and movie theater. Ok. Ok, exercise 2. In this exercise, we're going to do, you're going to answer this quiz to know how much you know about New York life. Les voy a dar un tiempito para que conteste, no importa. Si se confunde, después vamos a chequear las respuestas. New York's nicknames are the Big Apples or Gotham. New York City is the second most populated city in the USA. A third of current New Yorkers were born outside, fuera de USA. So people who live in New York, the third part, la tercera parte, were born outside the USA, o sea, no nacieron en los Estados Unidos. The New York subway is the largest mass transit system in the world. So the biggest in the world. Central Park, this is in New York, attracts 25 million visitors a year. 170 languages are spoken in New York City. Finish. Buenos días, Zulema.
Buenos días, profe, perdón.
Estamos en la página 76. Okay, let's check the activity. Number one, New York's nickname, estos apodos, ¿ok? Are the Big Apple or Gotham? Is it true or false? Amy.
Yo le puse fall.
False, it is true. O sea, a Nueva York se le conoce como la Gran Manzana, nunca he escuchado, la Gran Manzana o Gotham, este nombre, cualquiera de los dos. It is true. Tengo aquí información que dice, musicians first called New York the Big Apple because it was the most important place to play a concert. O sea, en un lugar, el lugar más importante para hacer concierto, por eso se le llamó. Le pusieron los músicos de Big Apple, la Gran Manzana. Y Gotham, ese nombre es, se lo puso the writer Washington Irving, el escritor. And it means Goat's Town, el pueblo de las cabras. Goat es cabra, entonces esto significa el pueblo de las cabras. Entonces, New York is known as the Big Apple or Gotham. Cualquiera de los dos se le conoce. It is true. Number two, New York City is the second most populated city in the USA. Abigail, is it true or false? O sea, ¿qué me puso? Porque no es que tenemos que dominar la información.
True.
It is false. It is false. It is the most populated in the USA. It has over or more than 8 million people in the city, more than twice the population on this, of the second largest city is Los Angeles. So, Nueva York no es la segunda ciudad más poblada, es la más poblada de los Estados Unidos, seguida por Los Angeles. Okay, so it is false. Number three, Emilia, a third, la tercera parte of current New York or New York people who live in New York were born out of the USA or outside the USA. Is it true or false?
True.
It is true. Most of people who live, the majority of people who live in New York came from Dominican Republic, Bangladesh, and China. Usted sabe que Estados Unidos es el país de la emigración. Y específicamente en Nueva York hay muchísimos emigrados. Por tanto, la tercera parte de esos emigrados no son americanos. Son latinos fundamentalmente, asiáticos, etc. Ok, number four. A ver su lema, si es que me puede responder esta. The New York subway is the largest, the biggest mass transit system in the world. Is it true or false? In your opinion,
false.
It is true. So, el metro neoyorquino es el más grande sistema de tránsito del mundo. So, it is true. Dice que it has 468 passenger stations, 468 estaciones, 369 kilometers of routes, 369 kilómetros de rutas, y more than 6 million people ride the subway every day. Imagínense, más de 6 millones de personas se trasladan en el subway cada día. So, it is true. Number five, Central Park attracts, this is a place in New York, 25 million visitors every year. Do you think it is true or false? Amy.
False.
No, it is true. Why? Because the Central Park has several lakes, muchísimos lagos, two ice rinks, dos pistas de patinaje, a zoo, a botanical garden, un parque botánico, and a running track and outdoor theater. So, tiene muchas atracciones este parque. Por lo tanto, many people from around the world visit New York in this specifically Central Park every year. So it is true. The last one, 170 languages are spoken in New York City. Emilia, do you think this is true or false?
True.
It is true. Aquí dice que English is spoken by 4 million people. Spanish is spoken by 2 million people in New York. Chinese is spoken by 300,000 people. Russian is spoken in New York by 200,000 people. And French, Italian, and Yiddish is spoken by 100,000 people. As you know, as there are a lot of immigrants in New York, of course, a lot of languages is spoken, okay? Are spoken. Bien, dudas con el vocabulario. Zulema después se tiene que igualar aquí porque este es vocabulario very important de Nueva York. Tiene que después categorizar aquí estas palabritas, aquí. Bien, seguimos a la próxima página, next page, 77, we're going to have a... a listening activity. Okay. Amy, look at the picture. This is a ferry. This is a kind of transport, a kind of ship. It's a ship. Okay, you're going to listen to this conversation between Kevin and Jasmine. And first of all, you're going to determine what are they doing first? What are they doing? And then, what do they decide to do next? What are they doing now? And what do they decide to do next? Okay? So you're going to listen and you're going to answer these two questions.
Track 18. Hey, Jasmine. I'm tired of studying.
Already? No way! We really should study, Kevin. We have an exam on Monday.
I know, what a drag. Ah, come on, Jasmine. It's Saturday. We should have some fun. Let's go out somewhere.
Okay, but we should definitely study tomorrow.
Of course.
So, what should we do?
I don't know. I don't have any money.
Really? Poor you. Maybe we could take the Staten Island Ferry. It's a lot of fun, and the best thing is, it's free.
Free? You're kidding.
No, let's check it out online. Staten Island Ferry. Here it is. You can see the Statue of Liberty, Ellis Island, and the harbor. And look, it says it's free.
Nice. So what time can we go?
Let me check. Saturday? It runs every 30 minutes from 6 in the morning till midnight.
How long is the trip?
Wait a second. Ah, here it is. The trip lasts 25 minutes. We can go from the ferry terminal in Manhattan.
Cool. We should go soon then. It's noon already, and I shouldn't get home after dark.
How come?
My parents are pretty strict. Dad worries a lot.
Okay. Should I tell my parents too?
I think so. Just so they don't worry.
Recuerda que tiene el track en la parte de atrás del libro. You have to answer these two questions. What are they doing at first? And what do they decide to do next? Okay. Did you answer the two questions? Okay, let's check. What are they doing at first? Abigail, what are they doing? What are Kevin and Jasmine doing?
And they are studying.
Me había ido de las, me salí del. Okay, Emilia, what do they they are studying and what do they decide to do next?
¿En dónde?
I te made the second question.
Sí, o sea, sí, pero ¿en dónde?
Okay. In here. What are they doing? They are studying. What do they decide to do next? Después, what do they decide to do? What? What activity?
They fueron a Hailey's Island.
In English, they decide to go where? They decide to go where? ¿A dónde?
Hailey's Island.
To the state. They decide to go for a trip on the Staten Island ferry. They decide to go for a trip, irse un viaje, on this ferry, the Staten Island ferry, okay? En el ferry de este lugar, de State. Ustedes saben que en Nueva York, cerca de Nueva York, no sé si saben, hay unas islas. Staten Island es una, Ellis Island es otra, y Manhattan, ¿ok? So they decide to go on a trip. They decide to go for a trip on this ferry, on a ferry, ¿ok? En un viaje al ferry. Ok. Now I'm going to play it again and you're going to complete this information. This is the information about the ferry. Okay? The sites, the ferry visits, the trips, the duration of the trips, and when does it open, the ferry opens, and when does it open, and when does it closes. Okay? This is very easy, okay? Les aconsejo que sigan el track. No sé en qué página está. Track 18.
Pages 128 y 129.
Okay. Listen and complete.
Track 18. Hey, Jasmine, I'm tired of studying.
Already? No way! We really should study, Kevin. We have an exam on Monday.
I know, what a drag. Come on, Jasmine. It's Saturday. We should have some fun. Let's go out somewhere.
Okay, but we should definitely study tomorrow.
Of course.
So, what should we do?
I don't know. I don't have any money.
Really? Poor you. Maybe we could take the Staten Island ferry. It's a lot of fun, and the best thing is, it's free.
Free? You're kidding.
No, let's check it out online. Staten Island Ferry. Here it is. You can see the Statue of Liberty, Ellis Island, and the harbor. And look, it says it's free.
Nice. So what time can we go?
Let me check. Saturday? It runs every 30 minutes from 6 in the morning till midnight.
How long is the trip?
Wait a second. Ah, here it is. The trip lasts 25 minutes. We can go from the ferry terminal in Manhattan.
Cool. We should go soon then. It's noon already, and I shouldn't get home after dark.
How come?
My parents are pretty strict. Dad worries a lot.
Okay. Should I tell my parents too?
I think so, just so they don't worry.
Okay, could you complete the information? Okay, Zulema, what are the sites the Staten Island Ferry visits? Here we have the Statue of Liberty. What else? Where else?
Ellis Island.
Ellis Island. Recuerden que esa palabra island, la S no se le pronuncia. Ellis Island. And what? What other site? Zulema.
Espera. No, no sé.
Who knows? Amy, what other places? What other place?
Harbor.
The harbor. It means el puerto. The New York Harbor, okay? Donde está la Estatua de la Libertad. So, Statue of Liberty, Ellis Island, and the harbor. Okay. Amy, seguimos. The ferry, esto es viajes. The ferry leaves, sale every...
Creo que estoy mal, pero bueno. 30 minutos.
Correct. Every 30 minutes there is a new trip of the ferry. O sea, cada 30 minutos sale un viaje diferente. Ok, Emilia, what is the duration of each trip?
55 minutes.
No. 25 minutes. Okay. The ferry leaves every 30 minutes, but every trip lasts 25 minutes. O sea, los viajes tienen una duración de 25 minutos. Abigail, when does the ferry opens? O sea, ¿cuándo comienza a trabajar? And when does it finish?
From 6 in the morning till midnight.
Till midnight, o sea, de 6 a 12 de la noche, the ferry is working, okay? So, from 6 till midnight, okay, muy bien. Para mañana tenemos esto que es gramática, que es el uso de should para consejos. Bien, les voy a compartir lo que les envío, que no es deber, esto lo voy a evaluar como group work, ¿ok? Este es el fotocopiable de la unidad anterior. Aquí tenemos, dice, read the poem. Aquí tenemos un poema. Does the author admire her brother? Eso es una yes or no. De acuerdo a lo que diga el poema, usted me va a decir, if the author admire her brother. Yes or no. How do you know? ¿Cómo lo sabe? Because tiene que sacar la información de aquí. Aquí le puse la 1 y la 2, esta y esta. In the second activity, you're going to find in the poem a sport or martial art. O sea, un deporte o un arte marcial. 3 jobs. 1, 2, 3. A free time activity. Como usted no tiene eso en el libro, tiene que hacer aquí. A type of music, a comparative adjective, and a superlative adjective. Eso está súper fácil. Aquí tiene que encontrar. Aquí les puse para que me complete. Y la tercera actividad es completar el cuadro con information about someone you know. Y esto no tiene que ver nada con el poema. De alguien que conozcas. His or her name. Compare with someone else. Por ejemplo, usted va a comparar a esa persona y usted va a decir, por ejemplo, el nombre María. La comparo con alguien. Ella es, o María es, más inteligente que, más alta que no sé, que mi mamá, que yo, o que mi hermana, o que, etcétera. Something you did with the person. Esto es en pasado. Algo que hicieron en el pasado. Last year we went camping. O we went to the beach. O we went to Mexico City. Algo que hicieron en el pasado. Aquí me tiene que trabajar en pasado. Ambitions. ¿Cuáles son las ambiciones de ella? ¿Qué es lo que ella desearía? Aquí se puede, por ejemplo, ¿qué es lo que... ¿Cuáles son las ambiciones? Por ejemplo, ella quiere ser una veterinaria. She wants to be a veterinarian in the future. Likes. She likes, she loves, she enjoys doing aerobics or listening to music or hanging out at the mall, etc. She's best at. Aquí lo que me va a poner, me lo tiene que poner con ING, porque mire, es como decir, I'm good at, soy buena, I'm good at playing chess. She's best at playing volleyball, doing math problems, etc. Afraid of, she's afraid of, bueno, no me tiene que poner la oración completa, porque aquí dice información, solo la información. She's afraid of dogs. She's afraid of lions. She's afraid of wild animals, etc. Solo información. No es si me quiere poner oración completa, ok. Pero eso no está complicado, está súper fácil. ¿Se entiende bien? Bien, aquí esto lo tengo como actividad fotocopiada. Bueno, eso ha sido todo por hoy. No sé, Abigail, le voy a...